beneath the sunny ocean shallows is a dark world of mystery, beauty, and terror. The deep ocean makes up most of the living space on our planet, yet we know surprisingly little about this vast underwater world or the incredible creatures that somehow survive there. If we peered into the most poorly understood environment on Earth, what spectacular and horrifying things might we discover? The ocean is distinct from many habitats because its broad regions are divided vertically by depth, creating what's known as the water column. The uppermost 200 meters of the water column make up the epipelagic or sunlight zone, the most bountiful and accessible region in the ocean. Throughout the sunlight zone, temperatures are relatively warm and flora and fauna receive plenty of sunlight. Seagrass and colorful algae create flowing underwater gardens along the seafloor. In some areas, reef-building animals like coral construct massive reef systems stretching more than 2,000 kilometers that support innumerable diverse species. The most important organisms in the sunlight zone are actually pigmented algae called phytoplankton. During certain seasons, blooms of these microorganisms illuminate shallow waters and coastlines, creating large radiant designs sometimes captured by orbital satellites. Phytoplankton also form the foundation of our global marine food web, supporting countless populations of zooplankton, crustaceans, and larger vertebrates. Below the sunlight zone, the ocean becomes dimmer, colder, and more barren. At these depths, light from the surface begins to dwindle, turning once sunny waters into a region of gray and gloom. The mesopelagic, or twilight zone, is a broad boundary between the ocean shallows and the deeper and darker worlds below. Some light penetrates the twilight zone, but not enough for photosynthetic plants to reliably convert sunlight into food. Common producers like phytoplankton cannot survive, so mesopelagic animals must rely on food that falls from the upper ocean. Bits of dead material and waste, known as marine snow, consistently sink into the twilight zone, feeding the many creatures that thrive in this gloomy environment. The twilight zone can be a dangerous place for small animals floating in open waters. The primary light source in the ocean shines from above, so predators often hide in the darkness and look for the silhouettes of their prey against the faint glow from the surface. To survive, many animals have adapted forms of camouflage and can effectively disappear in plain sight. Animals like the glass octopus have nearly transparent bodies and see-through skin. Only their eyes and organs are faintly visible. With this clever disguise, the glass octopus and other transparent creatures can safely float through open waters without attracting dangerous predators. Around 1,000 meters, we descend into the bathypelagic or midnight zone, a region of near total darkness and the single largest habitat on Earth. No sunlight reaches these tremendous depths, so the water is perilously dark and extremely cold, resting around 39 degrees Fahrenheit or 4 degrees Celsius. If bone-chilling temperatures aren't challenging enough, creatures must also endure at least 100 times more pressure than anywhere at sea level. The conditions are so extreme that, for many years, scientists mistakenly assumed the deep ocean was too punishing and barren to support diverse life. While photosynthetic organisms, like phytoplankton, cannot grow in the midnight zone, this competitive habitat still contains incredible diversity, home to creatures that defy our expectations and, sometimes, make our skin crawl. In the midnight zone, predators specialize in hunting in absolute darkness, so many rely on niche strategies to secure food. One ghoulish predator, the pelican or gulper eel, has evolved a whip-like body and a great gaping mouth to scoop up vulnerable prey. Hanging its jaws wide open, the pelican eel swallows everything in its path, including mouthfuls of seawater. Any excess water is ejected through the eel's gills, while its prey goes tumbling into its expanding stomach. These kinds of exaggerated shapes are common among deep-sea carnivores. Just look at the goblin shark, a menacing ambush predator with a blade-like snout and retractable jaws that thrust outward to snatch their prey. Goblin sharks are the only known living species of Mitsukurinidae, a family of sharks dating back 125 million years. Goblin sharks may have survived so long thanks to an extraordinary evolutionary adaptation. Using special electroreceptors on their snouts, goblin sharks can sense tiny changes in electrical fields, like those created by the nervous systems of living things. These electroreceptors allow goblin sharks to pinpoint camouflaged prey in the deepest, darkest waters. Not even the stealthiest animals can hide from this hunter's finely tuned senses. Alongside such strange-looking predators, ghostly apparitions can be found drifting through the deep sea, These delicate animals move slowly and gracefully, propelling their bodies with large bells and grabbing prey with sinewy tentacles. Deep-sea jellyfish are plentiful in the midnight zone because their soft bodies can tolerate extreme conditions thousands of meters below sea level. Among the many species of jellyfish in the deep ocean, very few are as large or haunting as the giant phantom jelly. Stretching up to 10 meters long, these graceful giants float like bundles of scarlet drapery. With their flowing tentacles, they feed on tiny animals like plankton and small fish. However, these jellies are so large and slow that other creatures may take refuge in their long arms, finding some safety in this dark and dangerous world. The strangest deep-sea creatures resemble aliens transported from the pages of science fiction. They may look like extraterrestrials, but these unusual predators belong to an order of hydrozoans called siphonophores. At first glance, siphonophores resemble strange-looking jellyfish, but they are much more complicated than they appear. A single siphonophore is comprised of a colony of tiny multicellular organisms called zooids. Within each colony, zooids are specialized to perform different roles. Some produce light or bioluminescence, while others attack prey with paralyzing toxins. Because of their colonial structure, siphonophores can take an astounding variety of shapes and sizes, from tiny translucent bells to glowing chains up to 50 meters long. Of course, siphonophores aren't the only deep-sea creatures that use some form of bioluminescence. Many animals generate spellbinding lights and colors that brighten the midnight zone, like fireworks exploding in the night sky. Though beautiful to see, bioluminescence serves many essential evolutionary functions. Animals like the coronet medusa, nicknamed the alarm jelly, create brilliant flashes of light that startle or disorient other animals. In the pitch-black ocean, these flashes are visible far and wide, deterring potential predators by threatening to attract even larger ones. Not all deep-sea creatures are bioluminescent. They can't generate their own light, so some use glowing bacteria, or symbionts, to create light for them. Colonies of symbionts help animals like deep-sea anglerfish attract their prey. These menacing creatures have oversized jaws and lores called esca attached to their heads, which house glowing symbionts. With its jaws hanging open, the anglerfish wiggles its esca to lure nearby animals. If any poor creature takes the bait, the angler snaps its jaws shut and devours the animal in one explosive bite. Below the midnight zone, we enter the abyssopelagic zone, or the abyss, about 6,000 meters below sea level. The abyss is the pitch-black bottom of the ocean, a world of both scarcity and surprising abundance. In this deep-sea zone, rare oases form around the carcasses of large animals, like whales, that come to rest on the ocean floor. When a whale dies in the upper ocean, its massive body sinks into the abyss, where it supports a new ecosystem, known as a whalefall. One whalefall can feed thousands of creatures for several decades. Attracted by the smell of meat, active swimmers like deep-sea sharks and fish are the first to arrive. Next come the opportunists, like octopi and crustaceans, which pick the whale's carcass clean over many months. Worms and snails feed on the fat and blubber, while bacteria slowly break down the whale's bones. Ultimately, no part of the whale is left behind. Whale falls are not the only plentiful ecosystems in the abyss. Vibrant communities of deep-sea life also gather around superheated chimneys called hydrothermal vents. These unique landforms spew billowing clouds of mineral-rich water that support an alternative pathway for life. Vent communities are unique from every other ecosystem on the planet because they form entirely without sunlight. Near the surface, photosynthetic organisms use sunlight to generate food. No sunlight reaches the bottom of the ocean, so bacteria and some archaea use the energy released by certain chemical reactions through a process called chemosynthesis. Around deep-sea vents, chemosynthetic microbes grow in sprawling mats, which sustain other organisms like vent crabs, bivalves, and colonies of giant tube worms. From the twilight zone to the darkest abyss, the deep sea is full of strange and terrifying secrets, and many more are left to be discovered. Nowhere on our planet is as foreign and mysterious as the deep sea, but the little we know is nothing short of extraordinary.